Welcome back to Press Start. I'm Seth, and today we're playing Hogwarts Legacy. So today we've been playing through the first day. We've had a lot of fun. It really has lived up to the hype so far. But we've come across a few things we do want to share with everyone. Maybe you're still downloading the game. Maybe you're playing it right now. Maybe you're still at work. Either way, these are a few things that we would have liked to have known at the very beginning, and we're hoping this will help you in your journey forward. The one part that is very time sensitive is the Twitch drops. So they are actually broken down to almost two different drops. The first one is a lovely Merlin cloak, and this is basically by either watching the early access stream on the 7th of February or on the 10th when the actual release date comes out. You do actually have to be on the Avalanche Software's Twitch stream itself in order to get this reward. So it's very important one of those 2 days you are watching the stream. The other part of Twitch drops is from the 7th to the 24th, so you have a little bit more time, and this is just basically gained by watching one of the streamers that is playing Hogwarts Legacy that does have the drops in the tag and enabled on Twitch, and basically by watching it in 20 minute segments you will be able to get one of these four rewards on the screen, moving from the silver dragon eyed spectacles through this list for all four items. Please also note as well that you do have to have a Twitch account and be logged into it when you're actually claiming these rewards. Even if you don't have the game installed right now, or maybe you don't have access to it until the 10th, it's still worth getting these Twitch rewards, because once you do have the game, that you will have access to these items within the game at that moment in time. You do also have to link your Twitch account to a Warner Brothers account. I do highly recommend you do this though, because you can get even more additional items for the game as well. So if you are interested in that, we do have a video that we did earlier in the week that's popping up in the top left hand corner of the video now. One of the things we were most concerned about with the game was the main storyline, and if you do progress it forward, does it eliminate some side missions? The answer so far from what we've seen is no, it does not. The further along you push the main storyline mission, you still get to do all your side missions too. Another big one was, if you choose a house, do you get specific quests for that house and basically excluded from it if you're in the other houses? The answer to that seems to be no. It just seems to be a purely like roleplay immersion thing, which house you choose from, and it doesn't really affect you by giving you additional quests. We have also been informed that if you do complete the main storyline mission, you can still go back and do all the side quests and all the puzzles that you haven't done so far, so don't feel like you need to do them all before completing the main storyline mission. Inventory within Hogwarts Legacy really does fill up fast. I highly recommend you keep an eye on your gear screen, and whenever you're checking it, if you do see some green numbers, that does mean your gear can be upgraded. I highly recommend upgrading to it. If there's a slot appearing that you didn't have one before, that's also a good way to upgrade too. And I also recommend that you do sell your old items too, because within this game, you pick up a lot of gear and you do run out of space very quickly. Also, money is very important early game as well, so selling it does help. Otherwise, if you're out in the world, you do have to destroy older gear in order to pick up that new gear. And on that side of things too, you can sell to various different vendors around the world. There are quite a lot of them. Another good thing if you do visit these vendors is they have a lot of very cool, unique items. For example, brooms. Last but not least is the open world. So within the open world, there are treasure maps. There are hidden spots, including things like whirlpools and chests underneath bridges and caves. Highly recommend exploring, having a look for them. There's various different things called Merlin trials, which increase your inventory space as well. And there's also a few eye chests as well around, where you have to cast the invisibility spell and then open them while you're still invisible. Otherwise, they stay closed. There are also various different arrows that the Alohomora spell does actually unlock. So if you do walk around and see level 1 lock, you need to unlock it with that spell. Please see our previous video about how to use that minigame and also getting the spell later on in the game. And that's it for this video, guys. We've really enjoyed playing this game. Day 1 down, day 2's coming up. Let us know in the comments, though, if you want anything specific. Other than that, I hope you all have a great day.